Chapter 16 has to do with lean operations. And we're going to focus up on a couple of points. We're going to talk about just-in-time, total production scheduling, and lean operations. So we're also going to talk about the seven wastes and of lean men, or how we identify the wastes so we can reduce them or eliminate them, and the five S's. We're going to calculate the Kanban size and what is a Kanban. So the five S's have to do with sorting. Think about this. You likely have a junk drawer at home, and you also have a drawer with perhaps your cutlery in. When you go to look for something, which one is easier? When you have it, everything sorted and segregated, it's much easier than looking through your junk drawer. Also, picture this. On a whiteboard or a blackboard, if I was to randomly write all the numbers from 1 to 100, just put them in any order, and then ask you, where is 17? You would have to look all over the board to find the 17. Now, if they're sorted from lowest to highest, or even from highest to lowest, you'll know exactly where to look. Also, think about this. What if I said there was two numbers missing from 1 to 100? Find them. If they're sorted in ascending order, you would simply scroll down and say, oh, 21 is missing and 68 is missing. Be very simple, but you'd have take a lot more time if things were not sorted. So even straightening things up and simplifying so that the numbers make sense and that they're easy to read and understand. Shining and sweeping. When I worked at the mine many years ago, what we did, they implemented a plan of cleaning at the end of the day. So half an hour before our shift ended, we would be required to wash down the tools, so wash down the shovels, take the jackhammer apart, wash it down, and clean it, oil it, put it away, so everything was tidy. So the next morning when we started work, we just grabbed the equipment. And so think about this in your own life. Have you ever spilled something on the counter? Of course you have. If you wipe it up right away, it's takes a few seconds. But if you're in a hurry and you leave it and you come the next day and that spilled ketchup or whatever it was, now you got to scrub it. So if you clean it quickly, it takes a lot less time overall than if you leave it. So that's what just shining and sweeping does. It also helps with safety. So there's not things laying around, things are clean and they work better. Standardizing, so you have all the same equipment, so you can have consistency of parts. So that would reduce your number of different parts that you have. Manufacturers have really tried to standardize, so they have less parts to keep in stock in case this piece of equipment needs to be replaced or repaired, etc. And again, sustainability and self-discipline, and recognizing that you need to review your work and recognize the progress. All right. Also, safety, which I've mentioned before, is important, and support and maintenance so that your equipment is not breaking down unexpectedly. There are organizations that will run, say, 16 hours a day, and then at night, a crew can come in and they will maintain the equipment, because the next day, if that equipment breaks down, it's a huge cost. They cannot get product out the door. And I know organizations that do that. So they don't want it to break down. So this is like doing an oil change in your car so your engine doesn't seize, because it will one day if you don't do oil changes. Kanban, simply a Japanese word for card. A lot of times these days, it's electronic. It used to be a physical card. And what it allows you to do is send a signal to your supplier or the place that you get. It could be another workstation in your building. Send a signal. It identifies how much you need, obviously what the part is, like all the details of the part, and and they will send you more, but they do not send you more product unless you ask for it. So that's what a Kanban is. There's production order Kanbans, which will cause a production run to be done. There are purchase order Kanbans where you send them to your suppliers. So there's various versions of a Kanban. And so it's simply a marker. So think about this example. If you ever have something where you use it and then there's a signal that tells you to you need more. So, and it can be in a checkbook, which you would have. There'll be a form. You'll have a bunch of checks, and then there'll be a form telling you it's time to reorder some checks. And these days, of course, you can do that electronically, but it's just a signal. It's no different to a degree than your low fluid washer fluid on your car. You have washer fluid in your car, and then there's a signal that says you're running low, and you top it up. It's along that line. There's even examples where if you have like a bin of, say, nails, you can spray a red line around the bin. So you fill it up with nails. You cannot see the red line. And then as you use nails, all of a sudden, as soon as you start to see the red line, it's time to order more. That would be a Kanban signal. So Kanban cards are can be commonly used in some companies. And it's called a pull system because rather than just getting product whether you need it or not, you only get product when you say, hey, I want some more. It's like putting your hand up and saying, I would like some water at my table. Rather than the waitress or waiter coming over and filling up your water glass whether you want it or not. So there can be a lot of waste when you have a push system. When you have a pull system, you don't get it unless you give an indicator through the Kanban card that you actually want the item. And that is chapter 16.